Hey guys, I'm Captain Zero, and today I bring you some news, some very hype news. I know Global has not been very crazy lately. There's a lot of people moving to Pokémon Masters and other shit. I myself have tried Pokémon Masters a bit. But yeah, Global is counter-attacking, guys. Global is showing some fighting spirit after the bullshit that was the last event information. I didn't even feel like talking about this event, honestly. I know that I'm pretty irregular in my videos, but I just couldn't do it. This event was like, ugh. Okay, but yeah, we have some hype news in this today. So, okay, first of all, this was known for some day already. For some days, it was data mined. But first of all, we're going to get Neo Neptune coming to Extra Island. This is pretty damn good because this Neptune changes to Striker type, Striker powerhouse. This is amazing, completely amazing because basically this Neptune can use color time skip kit, which will be very good for players that don't have a Striker experience captain, a Striker or Shooter experience captain, which are Perona, Jack, or Lock BB. So basically this Neptune, unless you're using a Cerebral Powerhouse team, is automatically better than the other Neptune. So yeah, other than that he doesn't change much. But yeah, there's a Shirahoshi dropping in that mission. There's a support Shirahoshi that has a very damn good support ability. Basically converts all non-natural orbs when you use Neptune special. When you use Neo Neptune special, I don't think there's another Neptune that can use it. I will have to check. So yeah, I would say keep an eye on this event because this pair, the Neptune and Shirahoshi, are amazing. Okay, we get the new event, which is Ace in the Hole. Ace in the Hole, it's a pretty funny name, I have to say. Ace in the Hole. You get it? Ace in the Hole, yeah, okay. Never mind. Ace in the Hole. It's the event for the celebration of Clash Ace release. This is the first ride I have seen in the game that comes with an event. An event just for the new ride. Okay. The first and the most important. The fuck. The first and the most important. We are getting the 3x experience Sunny for 7 days, which is amazing. Grab your your Jack friends, and yeah, and farm. This is going to be amazing for leveling up. I can't wait to do it myself. The second, we're going to get limited requests from Chopperman. Forget the set silent toads and Sunny to earn tons of pirate experience. That seems that are going to be. Yes, it's going to be missions that you get experience and you complete them. Also for Clash Ace, I think there's going to be some missions. We are going to get again the Ace, the Socket Island, which is a pretty nice way to get sockets now that they stack. You can also get this Ace. It's a free-to-play Ace that boosts free spirit attack by 175. It's good for free-to-play players. But yeah, the purpose of this island is basically farming final tome. So make a speedrun team and just go away and do it as fast as possible. They are going to put turtles on friend points, with friend points, which is whatever. They are going to put double pirate experience at certain islands. This is going to be interesting to see if there's something more worth than the turtles to farm. I will have to check for that. And as you can see, there is no skill up and no super success, but this is because this event, the September event, is still going. So basically, as you can see, the dates for the skill up and the double and the super success are here. And obviously the challenge turns on the map, etc. So this is basically a new event, but it's like an extra event. It is over the old event. But yeah. Next, there are a few gem packs coming. There is one gem pack that comes with candies, and Friendship Items, another one that comes with Thomas, Skillbooks, and there's a new one that comes with one legend pool, which is a very good legend pool because it's after Judge. Yeah, it's after Judge. As you can see, there's a lot of recent legends. It's up to the last legend, Jack. No, Bartomendis is not here, no? No, yeah, Bartomendis is here too. Bartomendis, there's Jack, there's Carrot, and as you can see, all the rates are the same. There's an equal chance of pulling all of the legends. If you want to buy it, it's a good chance, I would say, to get a new legend, to get a... It's not unequal chances like it has happened before, so if you want to try, you can be my guest. I personally not going to buy this pack because I my account is just absolutely ridiculous right now, so I don't really need to pull more. Yeah, this is shit that is already going, and we are getting Clash Ace, which is amazing. As you can see, it is the clash that we get for the 100 million downloads. There's a bit of a story here on the banner, which is pretty funny. He's going to be boosted for the next TM, which is interesting. And what here it shows what he does. He was powerhouse, free spirit, and fighter by 2.5 and HP. If HP is 50% or less, 3 times his damage. He's special. He deals heavy strange damage to one enemy. He changes block to matching. And if HP is 30% or below, boost the orbs for powerhouse, free spirit, and fighter by 225. If you don't have 30% or less, 2 times. And if you beat the maximum difficulty, you will get a ship. A new ship, which is absolutely hype because you get a ship for finishing the master the last difficulty. The ship is the ace ship, and you get the what it does is boost powerhouse, free spirit, and fighter HP by 1.2, attack by 1.5, and if you have less than 30% HP, 1.6. This is pretty interesting, honestly. Obviously, as a lot of people have said, this ship and this ace are more interesting for B2 Whitebeard. But I say you can use them on other teams. Depending on there's many content lately that just lowers your HP a lot, and you have little chance to heal. So this ship can be pretty good also. Lately, this Zuko Fest has been out for a while already. I'm not going to talk too much of it, but this Zuko Fest is basically a Zuko Fest where you can get B2 Whitebeard guaranteed. And BB and Ace come back, and also you can get 6 plus Ace as guaranteed. If you want B2 Whitebeard, it's an interesting Zuko Fest. If you don't really want B2 Whitebeard, B2 Whitebeard was guaranteed. One second. No. Wasn't B2 Whitebeard guaranteed? On the 9th pool, B2 Whitebeard is guaranteed, yes. So if you want to get B2 Whitebeard and you have the gems, go for it. Otherwise, not too much sense. The other thing that has been determined today, we are getting a new Zuko Fest after this one. You see, you will say, how many Zuko Fests? What the fuck? Well, this Zuko Fest is special because this Zuko Fest is a selected Zuko Fest, and basically, there's going to be very good rate boost, as you can see. There's going to be legends on the 2nd, on the 5th one, and on the 7th one you will get selected Zuko Fest exclusives, and on the 10th one also you're going to get a Zuko Fest exclusive, selected Zuko Fest. You can see the selected ones are pretty good, but the most important thing is that the 5th multipool, all posters are going to be a legend, a Zuko Fest exclusive. All posters are going to be a Zuko Fest exclusive on the 5 multipool. Again, I don't have so many gems, and I'm not going to pull because I don't need Zuko. I don't need 10 Usopps and 1 Boa. But if you want to pull, you have the gems and you want to go for that 5 multipool, it's a very nice multipool. Go for it if you want. So yeah, guys. that's basically all the legends, all the news. That's basically all the news. There's quite a bit of hype. I'm hyped for Clash Eyes myself. And yeah, also this here you have is for voting on Facebook for the next dual unit they are going to release. If you want to do it, you can do it now. But yeah, guys, that's all for the news. It's pretty hype. I want to see what Clash Eyes will be all about. And yeah, and after Clash Eyes we will get the TM, so don't relax too much. So yeah guys, thank you for watching this video, I hope you liked it, and I hope to see you on the next one. See you!